Hello my friends here at YouTube. I wanted to give you an update on a case I had just the other day. It's not a very impressive case, but certainly a lot I learned from it. And sadly enough, I don't want to admit of why we need to practice cookbook medicine rather than clinical judgment medicine. Now that's kind of a blow to me because I've always go with, you know, I wish I could do more clinical practice. I wish I didn't have to order all these tests on these people when they don't really need it. And if the diagnosis is clearly evident, why do I need an X-ray? Why do I need an ultrasound to diagnose something I know they have? So this lady presented with right lower extremity pain. It was in her calf, but it was high up, almost at the knee level, a little bit into her distal thigh, where she had superficial varicose veins, and one of them was very tender, red. It was warm to touch. So the diagnosis was easy, superficial thrombophlebitis. And if you don't know what that is, go ahead and you search in my channel for it. I'm sure there's a video about it. If not, I'm gonna put a link on the comments below. So I was orienting a new physician and I said, well, sometimes you just have to do the test because you gotta prove they don't have something else. She was hurting a little bit on the calf and she had no, I repeat, no risk factors for DVT, no recent travel, no recent surgery, no birth control pills, nothing. So I ordered the ultrasound at the lower extremities and boom! She had not only superficial thrombophlebitis, so I was right, but she also had multiple lower extremity DVTs, deep vein thrombosis. And if you don't know what that is, check out the link below. So anyway, so she had superficial thrombophlebitis and DVT. Treatment completely different. Superficial thrombophlebitis is treated with anti-inflammatories and warm rags over the area of the pain. It goes away in a week. DVTs, however, very dangerous. The blood clot can increase in size. It can dislodge and propagate and causing a pulmonary embolism, a blood clot going into the lung, which can be life-ending. It could be life-threatening. If not, it can cause significant cardiopulmonary compromise. If not diagnosed, it can cause core pulmonality, it can cause pulmonary hypertension, it can cause cardiomyopathy because of the excess work the heart has to put through. And PE is a very commonly missed diagnosis and probably the most common diagnosis that is missed and causing people's death. It's certainly nothing you want to play around with. So DVT is not treated at home with anti-inflammatories and warm rags. It's treated with blood thinners. Now, it used to be everybody got admitted to the hospital with heparin, switch over to Coumadin, and then sent home on Coumadin once the anticoagulant levels were high enough. Then Lovenox came in, which is a subcutaneous injection. So people who had a good insurance could be giving a shot of Lovenox. We need a prescription for once daily subcutaneous Lovenox shot and send home on that Lovenox. And then Coumadin, so until the Coumadin level increases to the INR of 2.5 to 3, and then switch over to Coumadin only. And here come Xarelto. Xarelto, new medication, once daily dosing. From the first dose becomes anticoagulated. Problem is, we don't know which patients have good insurance, which don't, which can't afford them, which don't. So we have a lot of patients who bounce back. We give the Xarelto prescription, they don't come back because they can't afford it, so they went untreated for a day. Certainly nothing you want to play around with. So this particular patient, we ended up admitting to the hospital so that once admitted, we could consult case management, we can make sure the insurance covers the medicine, make sure she didn't need anything else. And of course, made a workup of hypercoagulability. You know what I mean. Check why are they hypercoagulable, so that to see if there's anything that she needs chronically for treatment or prevention of future DVTs. So, lesson learned, sometimes it's better to be systematic in what you work up and what tests you order rather than good clinical judgment. And that's why, even though I'm resilient to admit it, cookbook medicine has its benefits. And that's the lesson for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Comment below, subscribe. We'll see you in the next one.